All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming to you live from Portland, Oregon, trying to break things down on the West Coast. People, we have some stuff to talk about. Spending time at the beach lately, having some great time. Hopefully, everybody else is enjoying their time. It's been beautiful weather out here in Oregon. I do want to take a quick second to say that I'm going to do a live sports chat again on recruiting day. So on the signing day, that's going to be Wednesday, February 2nd, is going to be a pretty fun time, I think. It's going to be a week from today, and it's going to be an opportunity for people to kind of jump in. If you guys are interested in joining me, sports.chat.503@gmail.com. Send me your link. I'll send you the link, and I'm going to run it like I did the last time, where I'm going to have a live YouTube going and have comments in the chat there, and then have the Zoom call as well, so you guys can hopefully be able to interact with each other a little bit and kind of reflect on this signing day. So that's going to be that for football. The big news of this week is CJ Verdell. And having Travis Dye go into the transfer portal and go to USC, I really haven't shared thoughts on that. I've been talking with other people, having people in. This is a time where I try to have a lot of different interviews and have a lot of different people come in. Again, I'm just trying to share people's stories, just trying to give people perspective and give Duck fans out there some content to be able to chew on. Because, again, Duck fans are hungry for this information. Let's go ahead and start with the idea that Travis Dye goes to USC. That, I think that for a lot of people was kind of tough because of the just nature of in-conference transferring. I think that just is kind of a new thing for people, and I think you have to get used to it a little bit. Think in terms of last year, having the best receiver that we had came from USC, right? So I think there's a natural thing where when it goes against our favor, we kind of upset with it, transfer portal-wise. And then when it happens in our favor, we're kind of happy with it. So I love the fact that the COVID year gave these guys an extra year. But for some of these guys, they don't need an extra year here. You utilize that extra year somewhere else just as an opportunity to go home. I think that's fantastic. He's getting married. And this is a guy who I don't know exactly what his NFL prospects are. Not to say he's not a great player. I think Travis Dye is one of the best we've seen lately. I think the guy, especially this last year, shouldered an incredible load on that football team and was the absolute guy. And so I do think it's important to kind of give him that respect up front, right? So, but I don't know what the grade is for the NFL. I'm not... on player analysis, that's not where my expertise is. I'm just a fan. I just watch the game. I talk about what I see. There's a lot of people who their job is to give people quality information. And, you know, a guy like CJ Verdell, who is looking to go to the NFL, and you know what? He clear-cut was the number one running back at Oregon and one of the better running backs in the conference, one of the better running backs in the country. And, you know, again, starting as a freshman gave him a leg up. He has done what he needs to do at Oregon. I don't think there's any unfinished business. And again, though, that's a term that might be corny to some people, but to a lot of these kids, they don't have that much time, and that's a unique opportunity to come back, say you're going to do it one more time, run it back one more time, unfinished business, whatever the case may be, and they just don't have that mentality. And that's fine. Travis Dye going to USC, I don't think it'll be a problem. I don't think Oregon's going to play USC if that's an issue for people. But even if they did, I would have no problem rooting for him. And obviously, I'm not a big USC fan, but I also want USC to get better. I think it's important for the entire conference to get better. And this is going to be an interesting year this year, the way USC's got so much pressure on it, right? So Travis is going to walk into a bit of a pressure cooker. I don't know if his offensive line is going to be as productive as it was here at Oregon. And I don't know if the offensive philosophy is going to really benefit him as much as the offensive philosophy that was here. Now, maybe the offensive philosophy changes this year with the new coaching staff, and again, that works, but I think it's much more personal for him. I don't think it's as much about football. I think it's much more about family, going back home. He's engaged. He's going to get married. He's going to start his family, and again, I don't know what his NFL career looks like. If he gets an opportunity in the NFL, I think that'd be fantastic, but there's a lot of guys out there that are very athletic, and there's not that many opportunities in the NFL. So it's just few and far between actually even get there, right? So and are successful. I mean, I look at it from the perspective of LaMichael James, the best running back we've ever seen at Oregon. You know, couldn't break into the league. You know, I mean, he got there. He got to play a little bit, but he never got that sustained play. That he was the best we've ever seen, right? Or at least one of. So it's hard for me to say that other guys who maybe are not at that same level are going to have success. Now, CJ, maybe his stature fits the league a little bit better. He's shorter, though. He's not that tall, and I do think that Travis Dye, when everybody says how small he is, Travis Dye's taller. So I think comparably, they're two different positions, right, almost. I think CJ is going to be an interesting guy. I think he might get an opportunity, and it's just all about that injury. And I think the NFL looks at those injuries very deeply, and coming off of such a bad injury last year, you know, maybe he regroups and is able to come back strong. And I don't know how that's going to impact his draft status, though, because of the combine or because of anything else that he has, the workouts or anything else that we're missing out on. So it's going to be interesting to see how that goes for him. Wish, of course, him all the best. And I did think out of the gate that he was going to leave. And I kind of did think that Travis was going to leave as well, but I just didn't think it was going to be through the transfer portal. I think that was the one we all didn't really see coming. But let's talk about this next year's running back room, right? Sean Dollar stays. I think he's absolutely the guy who has the most to prove, right? He's the guy who has a huge fan following and has had a really unique opportunity this year just completely open up in front of him. I mean, what a surprising opportunity that's just right now in front of you, right? So last year gets injured, has been healing and rehabbing the entire year. Now he's ready to go for this next year, and I think he's got a lot to prove. I think he's a great player, and I think it'll be a really unique opportunity for him to get the rock. You know what you have, Byron Carwell. I mean, he showed up on day one wearing the 21. I mean, you gotta love that, right? And he knows it, he feels it, the pressure behind it, wants to be great. His dad is very active in the spaces, love hearing them. The Carwell family is legitimately active in the Oregon community and online and everything else. I love their energy. I love what he's bringing to the table. And had him on early before he became a Duck, and he was talking about how he was ready right now. And I just love that mentality, right? So it was cool to see him get an opportunity, and he shined. And I think so. You have those two guys that are dependable. You know what you're going to get. Obviously, people are going to talk about Sean Dollars with the injury, but you can't control an injury, right? Injuries are going to happen if they're going to happen. And then the really interesting thing is about Seven McGee, right? What are you going to do with Seven? Is he more of a slot guy? Is he more of a guy who's going to be on the running back room? Could be in both. What are you going to do with him? It feels like he's leaning a little bit more toward the slot. And then you have this news of Jerick Broussard going into the transfer portal and people saying that he's ready to go and takes the trip to Oregon and has a great time. This guy's the 2020 Pac-12 Offensive Player of the Year. This guy was first five games over 100 yards. Hadn't been done since Adrian Peterson. I mean, this is a really, really unique player. And this is a guy who's coming in. If he comes in, he could be the starter on day one right now. I mean, and so that pushes a whole other conversation in with the Sean Dollars or Byron Carwell situation. So one would think these guys are really pumped up because they have this opportunity, and all of a sudden now you have a transfer, and it's a different sort of a vibe than with the quarterback, right? So when people have the Bo Nix transfer, maybe the Anthony Brown transfer, going back, you know, just keep going to all these different quarterback transfers, maybe there's a little bit of trepidation there. With the running back transfer, though, this is huge. This is one of the best running backs in the conference possibly coming to Oregon. And very fast, very strong, shifty, not that heavy, only 170 pounds, 180 pounds at the most, I think. But this is a guy who's very explosive running back. This guy is really good. So interesting things in the running back room. I think you're going to have some guys show up this year. You have to have depth in that room. You know that, especially after this last year. You saw the depth get tested. There's guys who are going to be in that room who are going to look to have an opportunity this spring, like an Aaron Smith, a walk-on guy. And you're gonna have some opportunities there for these guys. So looking to see what happens is always fun. This is a unique time of the year, January. Always a fun time to see, kind of project who's coming in, who's leaving, and what's going next for the Oregon Ducks. Thank you guys so much for watching. Really appreciate you guys. Have yourself a great one. Adios!